see my foot? See, when you go like that, so that you go like that, see, automatically, when you put this right on the point you came in, all right, so you just press down like that, you can stand. This is good because a lot of people like this better. See, now you can, and it's more painful, they go in this sector here, and they sit like that. See, how straight, you came in, look at those people more, that's one of them. All right, you see this? You can put this one this way. You can double it up, or you can circle this way, you came in, hang on. Okay, some people more flexible. That's the practice. What they commonly call a less rope or surfboard. Okay? So you can make this any way you want. So just go forward. This can be better straight. It's better straight than I have. Even forward in this direction is more painful. Okay, so you have different locks that you can apply that once you turn it. All right. Any question?
Guru?
Yes?
Can you do that face in the other direction, please?
This way?
Yeah, this way.
On the ramp, okay, so if I go like this, see, I pull here, see, because that pulls it. See, the first one is you step on it. Two, you kneel on it, but see, this is still standing. Then the other variation is you kneel down. They're all used for different situations. Third one is I step on the face, I sit. See, and the more I lean this way, see, and that's, see how this body holds it like that? Then you can pick this arm behind, or you can pick it up like that. Okay,
right?
All right. And then you just go like that. Okay? Or you can go back. You put the knee here. You see how I stand here? Now, it's much tighter if I take the face. Only thing I would be doing with this is my knife. But I would just put it. You see it in the box when I'm doing it. All right. You see how it tightens up here? Very quickly. Because you have face that way. That's what they always tell us, to put the face in that way. Okay? All right. Any questions? Then you have the slap. See how this thing here, in wrestling you cannot put, over here if you're wrestling, you know you cannot bring it past a right angle. Everybody knows that, right? Then you can go like that, see? You have double, see? Ride a horse, like that. And the more you come in, see there's a lot of different variations. See, this is the other one, like, I'd say that's Mike's hair. I just grab it like that, see? And I go, See, that's the, this is the, but you don't have to do that. All right. Any questions? The hardest part is getting there. The lock is easy once you get there. See? Okay, good. You can lock it up like this, see? That's very typical we found in many different systems. This one is nice and secure, see, because you can put it over this leg, feel? And you can put it over this leg, see? Right, it's double secure. And anytime you just see how this knee bends in case you're in trouble. Okay? And you like that, see, you go boom, boom. You can sit out if you want to sit out. But it's much better to be in a kneeling position than sit out. Okay, any questions? You got it? Okay, let's try it up there. I always like to bring out football as an example. See, every time you run the same play in football, notice that it never comes out the same way. Sometimes you go forward 10 yards, sometimes you go back 10 yards, sometimes you go forward 3 yards, sometimes you go back 3 yards, sometimes you land on the line of scrimmage. Sometimes you ran more to your left, and then went to your right. Because you cannot dictate the flow of his body. Okay, what you can do is inflict the pain. Now you notice that everyone you're working with has a little bit different flexibility. That's why in a regular class, maybe not on a seminar, you should trade partners all the time. That's a fact, right? Any type of energy exercise, you want to feel as many energy exercises. You want to feel very different type of resiliency. There are people who some locks it does not affect. So you have to flow to one that you know is affecting him. It's just like a play. You can use football. I like football because it's an example. You can use this play. It can work 5 games in a row for you. It could be your bread and butter play. And you may not be being playing a powerful team the next week. And you try that same play, it won't work. You try it again, it doesn't work. You try it 5 times in the game, it didn't work. And said, well, geez, it worked the first 5 games, see? Because it has to adjust to your opponent. Okay, now the problem, can I just have you over here in this position? See? Once you're here, see, Mike, what I want you to do is take your hand. See, once you're here, and you turn the guy like this sometimes, see, the arm is like that, okay? Then you have a guy that his hand is more like this, see? And his arm is more like that, see? And different, you have to, if you want to lock that hand, you have to adjust to it, okay? Sometimes when you get the guy like this, he's more like this. He's more in this position, see? Sometimes you just might want to kick here, support the back, put it here. So you have to adjust according to where his body is. See, sometimes his arm is so bent here that you can't use this one. Now I have to get it here. See, so you take advantage of his posture. You know, if I wanted to, let's say this is the only lock I knew, which is common in jiu-jitsu, Penjak Salat, Burr Salat, Kali Salat, Kun Tao Salat, etc., 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 right? But let's say his arm is bent, and that's the only one I hit like this to get it. See, that's the wrong one. I should take advantage here, see, and go into the lock. Okay? That's the point I'm trying to say. If you can't follow it, then different people have different flexibility. You have to feel it. Okay? All right, let's go into the next one. Okay, we're gonna go on the floor. When you scoop here, I might go like that. Look at it again. Why? Because when they go like that and they tap, this could be here. Why do you push this hand here so that I can no longer bring this arm to play? My butt. And she will push me so that her trapping hand will be here. All right, so therefore, when she scoops here, sometimes I can't bring this hand back to play. Right? All right, sometimes when she scoops, I use this hand here. See, because this is a throw in and of itself. Okay, so they do a lot of foot trapping in the Kali Salat. Right? So when you move your hand here, see, this is just to give you the flow. Okay, all I want you to do is get one technique in flow, see? Lock it up any way you want, see? Boom, see? And do that. Okay, this is what we call partial flow. Okay? So you scoop here, high, lock the flow. The instructor usually lets you do this. So then I get here, see? I take here, go in the flow. Boom. Then I take the middle line, go here, see? And we're done. Okay, that's it. That's good. All right, you got the idea anyway, right? Okay, let's try it up there. You with close quarter flow. It's the same principle. Okay. Now, notice that Kathy in her first motion is going to the kidney. Okay, now Kathy, I want you to go to the neck this time. See? Right? You're going to the neck. Now next time, go down to the kidney. See? When she scoops it, she goes down the kidney. Next time she goes around, she goes to the throat and go overhead again. See, that's overhead. See, she has three routes. Now, can you see what the route she's doing? Okay. Any questions on that? Okay. See how they're doing it? Now, why they use that format, because it's not